Okay. How are we all? Are we good?
Yeah.
Good. Splendid. Thank you once again for coming tonight. This has been a very special evening. It's lovely to see such a big turnout. I hope you're all enjoying yourselves. All the dogs are enjoying themselves, which is good. So without further ado, our esteemed author here is going to tell us a story. So would you very kindly put your hands together for Mr. Sean Laidlaw. Yay!
Obviously I've never written a book, I've never heard someone speak before, so I didn't really know what to say. So really this is just going to be a bunch of thank yous all kind of put into one. I've got like a slide chart kind of smashed together just to send thanks to the people involved in mine and Barrie's kind of getting here and talking to each other and stuff. So much alarm that I'm going to take off for too much. So first of all, this is my dad. So Dad, as some of you know, Dad, you can see he's not here. My mum's not here either. Dad's actually in hospital at the minute. We found out last year Dad's got cancer. 3 weeks ago, it progressed at a very rapid rate to the point where he's stuck in hospital at the moment. And he'll be out hopefully today, end of today. It does mean that he's not here today, which is a great shame for him. Great shame for me and a great shame for his family, but hopefully Nick is around here somewhere recording the whole thing. Dad's actually allergic to dogs. He's allergic to Barrie, but still, even with cancer, with being allergic to Barrie, he allowed us to kind of live in his house, live at home with him. That's the type of man that Dad is, and that's the type of man I'm aspiring to be. I was gonna get everyone to give a round of applause for that, but we're not gonna carry on people. So we can always raise the last to my dad.
Thank you very much. Cheers. Thank you guys. Okay, so
not good at crying, didn't it? Right, okay, so what I was gonna do, I was gonna show you all a video that most of you have probably seen before, some of you may not have, of what this whole story is about. Okay.
It really sounded like a child screaming. So we lifted up this concrete pillar and there was this tiny little dog.
As you can see here, exactly where Barrie's been living.
Our job out there was to disarm IEDs and homemade bombs. It took me 4 days to actually earn her trust enough to let me touch her.
New life, Barrie.
Hence where the name Barrie come from. We just thought it was a boy, so we just called her Barrie.
Have a nice trip, buddy.
And it wasn't until we did get her back and we showered that we realised that she was actually a girl.
I'm sorry.
Me and her become inseparable. Every day she come out on jobs with me, she was always with me on task. And not just that, she become the morale of the entire camp. Everyone was so pleased to see her. Every day someone had a brand new toy for her. I come home on leave, and the situation in Syria had really deteriorated in the 2 weeks I was at home, so I wasn't actually allowed to fly back. I was at home trying to organise her getting out of Syria, and I had this really good charity called War Paws that really helped me out. They were great. We worked together to get Barrie out of Syria into Iraq. She had to do 3 months of quarantine to make sure she had no diseases or anything. So for her, it was quite a lonely 3 months.
We're actually in the Eurotunnel now, driving all the way to Paris Airport, Charles de Gaulle Airport to pick her up, and then drive her back tonight. So if all goes to plan, then she will be with us tonight.
I was really nervous because obviously I left a tiny little puppy and then all of a sudden she's this big dog. And my concerns were sort of, will she remember me? Will she be the same dog that I left? It took about 10 minutes and then she all of a sudden sniffed my leg and then cowered to the floor with her belly sort of in the air for me to stroke.
Oh, we got that belly roll.
Oh, good baby.
That was the moment where I kind of knew that she remembered me, and that was an amazing moment. My little puppy had come home. And in the process of getting her back, everyone's saying that you saved this puppy, but at the end of the day, I don't think I saved her, I think she saved me. and should save a lot of the other guys out there from the thoughts and feelings that we have going through them situations we did. She's done as much, if not more, for me than I have for her in the sense of my own recovery. I may have got her back here, but she kind of made me better.
It wasn't just me involved in getting Barrie home or saving Barrie. The guys you see on this screen were Barrie's other dads, her uncles, the guys that made everything possible for me and Barrie to actually survive out there. They fed her, they looked after her, they played with her, they made her clothes. We actually made her own vest so she looked like us. Digger, this guy here, tore up an old plate carrier for us and made her own little vest, which is about this big, so it doesn't actually fit her anymore. These guys were sort of instrumental in looking after her. Even when I had to go home and leave Barrie all alone out there, and we found out I wasn't actually gonna be back to see her again. So from what I thought was a 2-week holiday was actually gonna be a lifetime without Barrie. So these guys looked after her. They actually done some really dodgy stuff to actually get her out. A lot of that you won't see in any of the videos online because I can't really say much, too much about it, but it is in the book, which is why the book has come around to tell the real story. These guys actually put their life on the line to make sure that Barrie got out, and I'm going to be eternally grateful to all of them, especially Andy. Andy was sort of Barrie's playmate while I was out there. When we got home, and it passed away, but I'm dead. He went out doing the job that we've done every day, and if you look behind you, you see a guy called Vass. He does this job as well. Dangerous jobs to a lot of people, to us, it's a normal job, but it does have very, very big implications. And Andy, unfortunately, didn't make it home. He had 3 children, a wife, and he just finished his pilot's license. And when he was coming home, he was gonna fly from Wales to England to prove that he can actually, an old dog can learn new tricks. Unfortunately, he didn't make that flight. But Andy was Barrie's favorite uncle, as you can see there. She was always playing with him. He was actually an older guy, but me and him were in the gym every day. He had scars on his knees from trying to do box jumps, and he was just too old to actually do it, but he gave it a good go anyway. So a big round of applause for Andy. Possible, but I actually got in contact with a lady called Louise, and Louise is actually here today. I've actually done something that Louise doesn't actually know about, so if I all get you just listen to this little excerpt.
Louise Hasty has a formidable timeline of making a difference to so many animals' lives in some of the most war-torn countries in the world. With a military background, she found herself rescuing cats in Iraq shortly after completing her military service out there and became well known for her efforts despite so many obstacles. In Afghanistan, she designed and built 3 shelters which housed over 100 dogs with a vet clinic. She ran the clinic single-handed, which oversaw countless operations saving lives of animals that had suffered extreme injuries. Louise left Afghanistan in February 2016 to start a new path, building shelters for animals in other countries where the suffering was immense. Louise is a true inspiration, and if we could all just be 5% more like Louise, the world would be a better place.
Louise, everyone. Managed to do it. There were so many problems and issues that came around, and Louise just within minutes, hours, just managed to get a new plan together. But that's just us. Now she does this every day, every week, every year, hundreds if not thousands of dogs. She's a trustee at a charity called War Paws. This is actually the charity that actually got Barrie home, and the charity that helped us, and Louise was instrumental in making all this happen. So if I can ask you just to Google War Paws, have a look at what they're doing. If you can, just donate a little bit to help out in what they're doing. It's truly incredible work what they do there. And Louise is just a truly inspirational woman. On to these guys. Mitch, Callum, Elliot, myself. These guys have actually been, as much as they may not know it, a huge rock for me. I still owned the company when I went out to Syria. I had a lot of my own issues I needed to square away and sort out that not a lot of people knew about. Again, it's where the book has come from. Not a lot of people knew the struggles. Not a lot of people knew what was going on in my head. Even people that I've spent time, like sort of the guys I was in the military with, I didn't really talk about a lot of stuff with them. They know more about me than anyone in the world, but even stuff I kept from them because it was just too much to sort of talk about. And these guys stood by me when things went wrong, when I made stupid mistakes, when I've done stupid things. They stood by me when I said to them that I'm going to go away for an unknown amount of time to go poke at things that explode and kill people. They sort of held the company together. And those of you that know me really well know that the company is my life, and I put everything I am into the company along with Mitch. So these guys, I wanted to sort of highlight the work and the, I don't know, sort of the comfort they are to me, the rocks that they are to me, even though they don't know themselves. So, the Fraser glass to Beyond Limits, please. The guy's there for me. Yes. Thank you. And Nettie. I met Nettie 3 years ago. She was my client, which is wrong. Nettie's actually seen me through thick and thin. As a friend, she was my friend first, she crawled out the friend zone. Hold on. She's been there through thick and thin. She's seen me make the worst mistakes and kept telling me I'm a good person. She's seen me do stupid things and kept telling me I'm a good person and she didn't get back to who I was. Nettie wasn't just a rock, she was a mum to Barrie. She is a mum to Barrie. She's now my fiance. And we'll get married. And Barrie. She can be the most annoying little thing in the world. Sometimes I would sell her for a pound, honestly. Yeah. But my life would not be the same. Is that sorry? In the battle. Short months later. But I wouldn't be where I am today if it wasn't her, and she wouldn't be where she was, where she is, if it wasn't for me, which is quite nice because I can now say that I saved a life without being too cocky about it. So I don't want to sort of ruin the end of the book for you, but the last line in the book actually says, spoilers, right? Spoilers. The last line in the book says, a lot of people think that I saved her, but in truth and in all honesty, she saved me. So just raise your glass to the little dickhead that I call my daughter. Barrie. Wait, sure. Say that to the last 5 minutes. Barrie.
So thank you all for coming today. Thank you for supporting the book. When you read the book, there's a lot of stuff in there that not a lot of you would know. And I've been really crapping myself about people reading it. I gave my dad the book first, and he wasn't too impressed that I had to quote about a lot of the stuff, but I hope that you guys read it from a good place. And now that a lot of you have got the book, if you can review it for me, tag us on social media, that'd be great. Really help us get the book out there. I feel the story can really help other veterans like me or other people that are going through dark times. So if you can, please forward it on to whoever you feel like needs it. Thank you guys very much. Thank you.